Hi everyone and welcome back to Lesson 5, Level 2. In the previous videos, we constructed this spreadsheet using the VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP functions. Now we're ready to move on to be able to order other equipment besides just the tennis balls. We wouldn't be much of a company if we just sold tennis balls, would we? On this tennis ball order form, we determined the grand total for an order of tennis balls based upon the variable unit pricing structure here using our VLOOKUP function. Next, we determined the shipping costs and discounts here in these columns by using another VLOOKUP and an HLOOKUP function. The zone also sells a wide variety of other products, and our order form must be able to include a variety of items and quantities, such as 2 tennis bags, 3 rackets, 2 packets of strings, etc. In our business model, each item has its own price per unit, and these prices do not vary by quantity ordered. This type of pricing is referred to as fixed unit pricing. To simplify things for now, we'll build our order sheet for these fixed price items. Don't worry, we'll incorporate the variable price tennis balls back into our order sheet later. Here we have a worksheet labeled Costs. This worksheet contains the different items that the zone sells, along with the description of the item and its price. We're going to refer to this cost lookup table from a different sheet called Orders. Orders contains the beginning format of an order form that we want to use. The customer can place an order for multiple items, and each item can have any quantity that they need. Once the customer fills in the item number, we want the description to automatically fill in the corresponding cell here, and once the customer fills in the quantity here, the total out here will automatically find the price of the item and then multiply it by the quantity requested. We'll start off with this description column and use a VLOOKUP function to go over to this cost sheet and retrieve the description from that table on that sheet. Looking at that table, we first check to see if our data is in a vertical format. Check. Next, the column used to look up the rows is the far left one. Check. And finally, are all the items sorted in ascending order? Check again, so let's do it. Let's go back to our order sheet and start our formula. Equals VLOOKUP. Our lookup value is this item number here in A3. Our table array is this lookup table over here on the cost sheet, so I'll go here and highlight all of the cells in this table. Comma. Now which column is our description in? That was the second column, so put in a 2 here. And finally, the item number that we're looking for up here needs to be an exact match to one of these values over here, so I'll select false. If we were to put in a true here, then Excel would do its best to guess at any prices for any items that aren't one of these exact matches. I don't want anybody ordering a new Porsche or something crazy like that that has an item number of 16 and Excel selling it to them for $67.25 just because of our error. We wouldn't be in business for very long, would we? So that completes our formula, and now we see that we have item 12 with the description of touring bag one size. Let's check out that to confirm. Go back over here, see if 12 is the same thing. It is, so we get to move on. Next, we want to determine the price per row of our order form, so the next thing we need to do is use a VLOOKUP function to get our price back from our cost table and then multiply that cost by the quantity ordered. Let's go here to D3 and start our VLOOKUP function. Equals VLOOKUP. The item number in A3, comma, the table array using the same range of cells that we used before, comma. This time we need the third column, so I'll put a 3 here, and then again we'll use false. Close our parentheses and hit enter to see if we get that part of the formula correct. Looks good, so the next thing we need to do is multiply this value by the quantity over here. Let me put a 10 in here just to test it out, to correctly total out our new row here. As we've almost completed this first row, I see that we've referenced our cost table multiple times, and before we move on and put our absolute references into the formula so that it can be copied down, I think I'll remember what we learned about earlier in the semester, about naming our cell ranges so that they're easier to work with, read, and remember. In earlier lessons, we named individual cells, but Excel also allows us to name ranges of cells for when we need an array or range of cells to have a name. let me go back over to our cost table, highlight it, and then go up here and rename it to prices. Now let me go back to our formulas here and replace the cell reference here with our newly named range called prices. That makes the cell easier to read, properly referenced, and ready to fill down. Let me go into this total formula and do the same thing. Since our formula is starting to get a bit complicated, I want to check it out using Excel's formula evaluator to verify that it's doing what I want it to do. Let me go up to formulas and click on evaluate formula. It looks like Excel needs to go and get A3 since it's underlined. I can hit step in and it will go get that 12 from that cell. Now step out, and our 12 is now embedded into our formula. Cool. The next step is to hit the evaluate key. It brings us back the cost of the number 12 as $59.99. Next, it looks like it needs B3, so I hit step in again, and it goes and gets me the quantity of 10 from B3. And now we have $59.99 times 10, so I click on evaluate, and that gives us the right answer, so let's go back to our order form now. I've put in a few more items here just to make it a bit more interesting, so let's complete this order form by creating our formulas for our total order, our discount, shipping costs, and grand total. For our total order, we just want the sum of all these cells immediately above here, so I'll just put in our sum formula here, referring to this range of cells. Cool. Our next step is to calculate the discount. Our discounts are located here on a discount sheet, go figure. The zone offers a $150 discount on all orders of at least $5,000, a $400 discount for orders of at least $10,000, and a $1,000 discount on all orders of $25,000 or more. To calculate this discount, we need to use a lookup function that looks up the order size and then refers to our discount lookup table here and returns our discount. If we look closer at our discount table, we see the total order value here in column 2, and the value that we want to return here is in this column to the left of that lookup column. If we remember our conditions needed for our beloved VLOOKUP function, it needs the lookup column to be on the left. Now what do we do? One option is to reconfigure our discount table here and shift our columns around so that this total order value is over here to the left of our discount. But that's not always an option, since this table may be locked or created and maintained by a different department, and every time the marketing department alters or reissues the discount structure, our spreadsheet breaks. So we may not have the rights to move this stuff around just to make our lives easier. Evidently, it's not all about me all of the time. Luckily, Excel has an alternative to me fixing my narcissism in the form of another lookup function called lookup. Lookup is from an age long gone and was mimicked from a competitor by the name of Lotus123. Excel implemented it years ago and has kept it around to ensure backwards compatibility with older spreadsheets. So let's go here to this cell, equals lookup, looks up a value either from one row or one column range or from an array, provided for backwards compatibility. Lookup is very similar to VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP in that the lookup values must be in ascending order, but notice that it only has three parameters instead of four. It's missing that last true-false parameter, so you can only do approximate lookups where the last parameter in an HLOOKUP or VLOOKUP is true. It can't do exact lookups where the last parameter is false, like our newer V and H lookups can. One advantage that it does have for us, though, lies in the fact that the lookup column, or in this case the lookup vector, doesn't have to be the leftmost column like the V lookup or the top row in an H lookup. Let's demonstrate using our discount cell here. The lookup value is our total order value right here. We now need a lookup vector, and we can click on our discount page and select the range of cells that we want to compare our total order value against here in column B, comma. The final parameter needed by this function is the result vector. This vector has to have the same size as our lookup vector, in this case, four cells right next to each other. These four cells can be in a horizontal or vertical configuration, but in our table here, we're lucky enough to have the matching four cells, our result vector, right next to our lookup vector, so I'll just highlight those, close out my formula, and hit enter. Now let's talk through this formula. We look up this value in this lookup vector, or range of cells, and then return the matching value from the result vector, or range of cells. So it calculates that our discount is $400. Since this is a discount, I want it to be a negative number, so let me put a negative sign right here in front of it. And I like that format, so let me test it out a bit. Remembering our order value thresholds of 5, 10, and 25,000, so let me overwrite this formula for a minute. Let me put in $49.99, that's still a zero, check. Change that to 5,000, should go to 150, check. Let me change it to $99.99, one less than our 10,000, still 150, check. Change it to 10,000, 400, check. Put in $24,999, still 400, good to go. Finally, we'll put in 25,000, gives us 1,000, boom. We'll finish up these last couple of cell formulas in the next video. See you in a minute.